Buzzcocks, my name is Otto C and welcome back to Oxygen Not Included, where today we will build a better setup for a metal volcano. We will not use this one, because just putting a bit of water in there damages the auto sweeper because the steam is just too hot. So instead we will try to figure out this one up here. That's a copper volcano, I think. Let's give a bit more room, or let's plan out the thing first. We will need above something like this. That and then up here we will have the entry. So that out, we take all this out. We will wait with that part till the end. That means we are coming down here and we will build a ladder up there. Then of course we need this here. In order to make a bit of progress, let's have a bit of priority there. And we also need to pull over off this wire here. There we will have a joint plate, and once we have that closed off we can also place it in there. We will also need pump. Vacuum everything out. And we will then eventually need of hydrogen in there for cooling. Let's try and build this pipe as well. Right, that should give them quite a bit to do. And that probably is good. good part of our gold supply going through there for the wire. And I think we will just wait until this first part is done. And then see on what's next. We made a bit of progress, so now we are pumping out the gas in here. However, that does not really do much as long as we do not have a lock here. However, we do seem to have kind of a lock because down here we have polluted oxygen. And the gas that we pump in here, the hydrogen, cannot mix with that one. So at least the density of the gas goes down. So hopefully we get a bit of petroleum pretty soon. So we can have our liquid lock here, and then we can finish this setup up here, build the walls around, and lock. That should then clean everything out. Let's prioritize the rest as well. Once we have also vacuum down here, we can drop in a bit of water down there. Does not really matter if it turns to ice immediately. As long as we can keep the vacuum, then have this dug out. Maybe we should not add the water before we have dug this out, because if we would then turn the water to steam, it would rise up and mess up our setup. So I think we can already start digging this out. Because we have to make sure that this thing is working properly. Analyze that signal and clean everything up. It's the same priority. Alright, it's time for another skip ahead. Now that the analysis is done, we can see we have 24 cycles before it gets active again, so that should be enough time to finish everything up here in good order. And what I noticed is this machine actually needs a liquid vent that goes back down, something that we forgot here, because there we have it like this. That does not really work. So let's remove those and break open here. Here, and then we will have to pump things out again. And before doing that, we probably should break the line. Otherwise, we would push in more hydrogen while also pumping it out. That's not an ideal scenario. Here we also need to clean up a bit. Priority 7 on that. We are almost good to go because I think with 24 cycles, it's pretty safe to let in the water now. Let's finish the things up there and then also fix the issues. Down here they started with the cleanup, so let's put in the pieces that we are missing. Get that way. We will need bridge. Because we wiped up quite a bit. Up here we have a bit of water in here. It's not enough yet, but we can deconstruct this one. And we don't need that anymore. Instead, we will place a vent there. Here. And we will deconstruct this one. And then, once we have closed off this lower part, we can let in hydrogen and close this one up. We probably also need to deconstruct this one because there we need a bridge. We still need more water down there. However, as we have recently improved the morale of our duplicants, I think we can see if we can add a few more skills here or there. Maybe not for everyone. Not sure if I need this one. That seems good, and that. here. So they move quicker when in the suits. Right. So let them finish this piece up here as well. Here we have to set for water, keeping an eye on this one. We do not need more water than necessary. So I think we are on a good way. And here they seemed to be done, so let's clean up this mess again, and then we can close off. However, up here, what we forget to plan out was the system to take things out. We can have this here, and then we need that's made out of gold. Actually, I want that out of steel. Are lacking steel? Because we are lacking iron. Let's make sure. Okay. Close off here. Let's do this quickly. Okay, the water is not yet near the boiling point, so still have a bit of time there. Then we can plan this out and move the things out here on this side, and then close things off again. As you can see, I already had everything closed up, and then I noticed that will not work. We might get power out of the setup, but we also want to get copper out of it. So that should be good for now. We managed to complete everything, as you can see down here. We already produced some steam. And up here, the copper volcano now is active, and it will erupt soon in half a cycle, and then we will see if this actually works as we have planned it. But I am optimistic. At least it should work better than this setup down here, because this one had no active cooling. This one has, and as we have built this out of steel, that should be sufficient high enough so that it does not melt, because the steam should only reach 125 degrees before it's cooled down again. And then research wise I have started here the last six ones, So I intend to do the research that we can on this one and on this one, so that we can have that out of the way. And then we will have to go topside for astro research, where we need the telescope for. The telescope? Or do we need to do space missions to bring things back? It's been a long time since I played Oxygen Not Included with rockets. So, we will see. And this one is erupting in just a few more seconds. And there the copper goes on the wire. This is connected all through here and then down here, where it connects with the other one. I hope that works. I mean, copper has already cooled down quite a bit here. Here it should go that way, yes, because we can also store copper in here. Right! Successful episode for once. Hope you enjoyed it, and we will see what we will tackle next, so don't miss to tune in then. Goodbye for now.